What's up, everybody, and welcome back to my channel. As you know, Braxton Family Values star Tamar Braxton allegedly attempted to take her own life a couple of weeks ago and is now back, has regained consciousness, and is still in hospital at the moment. And that's why I'm particularly amazed, jaw-dropped, disgusted, like just shocked by WE TV's response to the whole thing. According to Tamar's boyfriend, in the leaked 911 call, he said that she felt as though she was being completely misrepresented, cast to look like the villain as always, and that she had tried to take things up with the network, but they ignored all of her concerns, and they locked her into this contract that she no longer wanted to be in. And then she felt as though her head was, her back was up against the wall, and she had no other choice, and she was just so distraught by the entire situation that she attempted to take her life. So you would think that with things kind of taking an extreme turn in that direction, the network would kind of go, you know what, from a human perspective, if this show is hurting this person this badly that they allegedly attempt to take their life, maybe we should just shelf this thing because the show is not more important than this woman's life. This woman put us on the map 10 years ago when she debuted on the show with her family called Braxton Family Values. I had never heard of WE TV until Braxton Values came along, and I'm sure millions of other people were in the same boat. So you would think that they would have that level of respect, love, gratitude, compassion for Tamar. Whether, you know what, I shouldn't even qualify it that way. Whether or not she brought big ratings to the station, like, you should just feel that way for other people just on the basis of humanity alone, but I digress. But no, that is not the direction that they are taking. Now that Tamar has allegedly regained consciousness in hospital, WE TV took to Instagram to release a statement that might kind of just make you kind of crinkle your brows a little bit. Listen to what they had to say. They posted a black screen with a caption that reads, and I quote, "Tamar Braxton has been an incredibly important member of the WE TV family for more than a decade, and our first concern is for her recovery and well-being. Given the current situation, we are postponing the premiere of Tamar Braxton Get Your Life until September 10th. This series was conceived by Tamar and is a real portrait of a dynamic woman juggling the demands of being a single mother, a new relationship, and her career. We know when the time is right, Tamar's fans will relate to seeing this honest portrayal of her life, but at this moment, we're joining with her fans and sending strength and healing in the hope that she is getting the support and help she needs at this difficult time." Did you kind of catch that? First of all, how disgusting is it that they are only postponing the show, not just like scrapping it altogether after seeing the toll it's taken on Tamar's mental health? But number two, they go, "an honest portrait of her life." The crux of Tamar's issue with them is that she feels as though she's being misrepresented. So here they are finding out that this woman who allegedly attempted to take her life woke up in hospital and is still under psychiatric hold, allegedly. They go, "you know what, I don't know what she's talking about. This is an honest look at her. By the way, yeah, real sad what she tried to do back there, but we're gonna move forward with this thing. We're choosing like this random date out of the blue that she obviously could not provide any kind of insights or, like, you know, opinions on because she's been in the hospital this whole time." Like, what? Like, it just goes to show you how little this network legitimately cares about Tamar Braxton. Like, my stomach is in knots seeing her being so disregarded this way. They're claiming to care about her, but they don't even consult with her about whether or not this show should be going forward. Like, there's been many shows that have been pulled for scandals when the stars do things that are wrong. Like, you know, Paula Deen lost her cooking show after her racist tapes were dug up, like, etc., etc. So why would they not just drop this? It's not that Tamar misbehaved. No, it's because this has taken such a bad toll on her health and her life that she attempted to take her own life. Why not pull the show? It's not more important than Tamar's life. And not only that, not only did they release this statement, what they did while Tamar was, I think this was around the time where we were still in limbo, wondering whether or not she was still allegedly unconscious or if she regained consciousness, but they dropped the trailer for this show that allegedly put Tamar in the hospital. what is the actual problem with Hollywood? Like, you know, when you see like celebrities snapping, remember Britney Spears shaving her head, I believe it was in 2008. You see what's going on with Kanye West right now. He's in the middle of a nervous break, in my opinion. And you see what's going on with Tamar, the Anthony Bourdains of the world, like people who seemingly have it all of a sudden just snap like this. And it's becoming more and more apparent that the reason is that Hollywood is a very, very toxic place that does not give a crap about literally anybody. Do you guys remember when Whitney Houston died? She died in a hotel in Beverly Hills. And what happened? It was on the night of the Grammys, and Clive Davis had his Grammys pre-party that night. And so what happened was that Clive Davis, the guy who founded her and mentored her from like teenagehood to adulthood, who should be like on his knees, shocked, devastated at the whole thing because of how close he was to this woman for decades, over three decades. What did he do? He did not call off his party. He continued to have his party just a couple of floors down from where this woman he's known and mentored for decades died just a few short hours ago. Like, it is a very creepy place, and I'm seeing more and more like why people snap and lose their minds. And I'm not saying that in a derogatory or they're going crazy. No, they literally lose their minds and cannot take it anymore because it is such a filthy, disgusting place. The fact that WeTV continued to drop the trailer for the show is disgusting. Their half-assed Instagram statement talking about how they're gonna only postpone the show to some random date that they just selected without Tamar's input while she was unconscious is disturbing. Like, I literally, you know, I have no words for this station beyond this, because I think that all they've shown is that they care about money more than human lives. And yeah, I think we all should be pretty disturbed with the way that they've handled Tamar's situation. And you know, I wonder how they treat other employees who are not like big names, you know, behind the scenes, because if this is any indication, I really do worry for anybody working within this network. Guys, are you surprised by WeTV's response to Tamar allegedly, you know, attempting to take her own life over the way she was portrayed in this upcoming show that they're still gonna go ahead and drop? How would you handle things differently if you were at WeTV? Let me know all of your thoughts and opinions in the comment section down below, and as usual, we'll chat. That's all for now. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.